Hey everyone, Joe here. Well, today I'd like to talk to you about some software that I use to back up my files, folders, and photos and videos here on my computer. And that's Ashampoo Backup Pro. Now, I use Backup Pro 11 to, like I said, backup all my files and stuff. And I really do like the software. Now, I am an affiliate with Ashampoo. However, they are not paying me to make this video. This is actually software that I use every day to make sure my files, you know, don't get lost. And I do recommend everybody always back up their files and folders. Matter of fact, I've been using this software for quite a while and I really do enjoy it. So I thought I'd share it, especially since this software offers such a great value that it's kind of hard not to recommend it. Now, the thing is with software, it can be all subjective. You know, I can tell you how great it is, but unless you actually see how it's actually been used and how to use it, it's the only way you can actually get a good idea if you like the software or not. So to do that, I'm actually going to demonstrate to you how easy it is to set up and actually to use Ashampoo Backup Pro 11. So let's hop over here to the computer. Okay, everyone, to show you how easy Backup Pro can be to use, let's actually create our own backup. Over here, you have a few options. Overview, new backup plan, which is what we'll be using. Restore, reports, rescue system, settings, and services. Let's click on new backup plan so we can create that new backup. Okay, now we have backup storage type. And this right here is to actually, for you to decide where you want your backup to be stored. Most people will actually choose local drive or network drive. So if you want to store it on a local hard drive, a USB connected hard drive, for example, or on a network connected drive like a NAS, you can choose this one. But there are also other cloud options. For example, we have Dropbox, Google Drive, and Microsoft OneDrive, and a few other options. For this tutorial, we're going to choose local drive and click next. Okay, on the next screen, we have select backup drive. Now, on select backup drive, we can actually choose where we want our backup to be stored. As you can see, I have one drive listed here as backup, and it's also letter Z. Now, that's the one I'll actually have my current backup set to. For the tutorial, I'm going to go ahead and choose it again. And then let's click next. Okay, our next screen here is create or import. We have the option to create a new backup plan, or we can import the settings for another one. For example, you see my other backup here listed as full backup right here. So if you want to do that, you could click this one and choose that. But since we don't, we actually want to show you how to create a new one from scratch. Let's just click here and call ours test. Then click next. Now it asks you, what would you like to back up? You have the option here for entire drives, which is normally easier for most folks, and one I actually do recommend. But in case you want to create individual files and folders, for example, if you had one drive that has one folder in it you actually want to get, you can choose that one. For this tutorial, we're actually just going to choose entire drives. Then click next. Now the next screen here asks us to select our source drives. As you can see, we got a lot of hidden partitions, which is normally common, especially when you buy a computer or Windows sets things up. And we don't need all of those. Matter of fact, it also lists, you know, backup drive to be backed up. We don't need to back up our backup drive. So let's uncheck it and all these other hidden partitions. Most of these are just hidden files and they're not important. What's important here is we want our C drive, which is normally what most people have their operating system installed on. For example, I have Windows 10 installed on this. Then my work folder, you know, work drive, and my files where I keep all my main files on another hard drive. Those are the three drives I want backed up. So we're going to choose those for this tutorial as well. And click next. Our next screen here is to ask you if you want your backup encrypted or not. If you don't have any sensitive material, then you probably don't need to encrypt your data. But if you do have encrypted data, you can choose this. However, it will ask you to create a password. And if you lose that, you will not be able to access your backup. I recommend most people, unless you have sensitive material that you don't want leaked. For example, if you work for a company and carry some work home with you, you won't encrypt backup, but for the most people, I actually do recommend just do not encrypt your backup. So let's choose that one for this tutorial and click next. Okay, our next selection here, we have compression settings. Now, I do recommend compressed backups because it also is faster and takes up less space. That means you can fit more files onto your backup drive. But in case you need more compatibility, you can choose Do Not Compress Backups. For this tutorial, I'm just going to choose Compress Backups. And let's click Next one more time. Now on our next screen here, we have Version Settings. Now what this is for is actually to decide what kind of backups you want made and how many of those backups do you want stored on your backup drive. Now I actually use the default here at Infinite Incremental Backups. These are normally smaller and faster. But if you want large backups, or actually full backups regularly, you may want to choose the second option. Most businesses will actually use this option right here. That way they can keep full backups of stuff and keep those backup regularly. But for most home uses, you'll want at least one major backup, then the rest will be incremental. So if you choose Infinite Incremental Backups, it'll make one full backup for you that should contain everything. Then from there on out, it would actually just back up the files and stuff, or make any kind of changes to the files to back up, and much smaller ones that way. So it's not backing up everything all over again. This is normally much smaller and faster. Now we up here with backups to store. Now to help you understand this, if you had, for example, wanted to make backups every day, this was stored the past 28 days worth. So therefore, it can store up 28 days before it actually starts deleting the oldest backup. For this tutorial, and since it's also the default, I'm going to just leave it at 28 and choose Infinite Incremental Backups, since that's what I recommend for most home use. Then let's click Next. Now we have finally come to Backup Schedule. If you don't want the A-Shampoo Backup Pro to ever start doing its own backup, you want to manually do it each time, you can choose No Automatic Backups. You'll have to start those manually each time. But if you wanted to set, for example, set it up when you're not working, or if you leave work, and for example, you don't leave work at a scheduled time, you can set it to that. But if you have a set time you'd like it to back up for daily, for example, it listed here at 1 p.m. or 1300 hours, you can choose that one. They also have a weekly backup, so you can choose that one particular day and what time you wish to start. If you have your own special way you like things backed up or what times, you can choose advanced. Currently has a default one here, says every day at 1300. Let's click remove on that one, and let's click add to create our own. Now it asks you when you want it to start. It says daily, day of the week, or month. Let's click on day of the week. So now you can choose which day you want it. And let's choose Monday. Now you're probably thinking, well, this is much like the other one. Well, here's the difference. Here you get to choose your step size. For example, one will have to be every day. It'll run every time. So every Monday, this backup will run. If you choose two, it means it will run every other time. And if you choose three, it means it will run every third time. Now, for example, I'm going to choose 2 here. And what that means is this backup will go into effect every other Monday. So therefore, if you want it to go every other Monday, you'll get 2 backups a month. And you can click OK, and it adds that. What's really great about this, you can also add an additional one. So if you want to do another one day of the week, for example, a Friday, or say a Thursday, and you want to run every Thursday at 1300, you click OK. So now it's going to run a backup every other Monday and a backup at Thursday, every Thursday. So those can be some options if you want. Like I said, it's got plenty of ways to set it up to fit most people's schedules. Let's go ahead and click Next. Okay, now we're here for missed backups. Now what missed backups is in case you come in from work on a Tuesday and you had a backup scheduled for Monday. What this would do is tell the computer, as soon as it starts up, to go ahead and start that backup it missed. However, you can choose to skip missed backups. That way, if you come in on Tuesday and you don't want it to have your backup automatically start, you can choose that. However, do keep in mind, even if you do choose make backup at next opportunity, you can't always pause the backups or cancel them to the next time when they start running on your computer. I recommend most folks just leave it as make backup at next opportunity. And let's click next. Okay, now we have power settings. Now you have a few power modes here. This is normally for laptop computers and stuff. Most desktops don't really matter. You get to choose if you want to allow sleep mode while making backup, or allow sleep mode only if running on battery power, or prevent sleep mode. I'm running a desktop, so it doesn't really matter to me. And I think it really won't matter to most folks. Like I said, if you're running a laptop and it happens to be running on battery, and you may want to take that into consideration. Now, up here it says automatically shut down the computer after backup. If your backup's going during the day, you probably don't want this checked. But if you're like me, you like to start your backups like at 2 a.m. in the morning. That way when you're not when you're using the computer. And you like to be shut down so when you do finally come into work, the backup's already computer's actually shut down and not running for no reason. You can choose that. And I really do recommend it, like I said, if you're going to have that doing at night. Now, do keep in mind, if it finishes the backup and you're still using the computer, it will prompt you if you want to keep the system running or not, and you can cancel the shutdown. But I'm just going ahead and just check it, and let's go ahead and click next. Now, it also has options for keeping backup reports. And it has a few options here where it can actually tell you, what's happened in your backup, why you like if it messed up any. And this option right here, number it keep, default's 27. Let's click next. Then you have backup reports, like email I just mentioned. You can tell you, hey, you can send you an email report. And this tells you the summary of everything. And now I'll go ahead and click next. And it's going to prompt you, do I make changes to the device? Of course, yes. Okay. Now here we have an option. We can start a backup plan now, create a rescue system, or go back to main menu. Now, if you haven't created a rescue system, I recommend you go ahead and click that. It will help you create, some bootable disk or thumb drive in case, your system actually does completely fail and you need to replace your operating system drive. You can put it boot up off that thumb drive or disk, wherever you choose, and then be able to restore your operating system from a Shampoo Backup Pro. Now, like I said, if you wanted to, you can go ahead and click Startup now and go ahead and start your backup. Now, I'm not going to do that because I've already got a backup in this system. So I'm just going to go back to main menu. Okay, everyone. Now I'd like to show you how easy it is to restore your files or drives in a Shampoo Backup Pro 11. Now, I have my backup plan here. I have listed and named as full backup. And here's our actions for that particular backup. So let's go down here to restore backup. Now we're going to have three options given to us here. Files or folders, which is good in case you accidentally delete one particular file and you want to recover it. Drive partitions. For example, if you have a drive, divided into multiple partitions, you can restore just those partitions. Or complete hard drives, which can restore multiple partitions, entire drives, anything on one physical drive. Since I think most folks would probably use files or folders or complete hard drives for the most part, first I'm going to show you the complete hard drives, and we're going to see that one first. So I'm going to click next, and it's going to prompt me here on the computer, and here we go. Now we can choose our backup date. Then when what drive we want to back up. For example, if I wanted to restore my operating system, then I would use C drive here, which I have Windows installed on. Then I would need to choose another drive from my that's installed on my computer. For example, if I wanted to install Windows completely, restore it from a drive that went bad, I would simply choose C again, which is where I would have Windows installed. But since I can't actually show you that by actually restoring anything, I'm just going to pretty much tell you after you click on it, you click next, and you're pretty much good to go. It starts the backup process. So let's go back here. And the other one that most folks will use is they accidentally delete some file or folders, and they decide, oops, I accidentally deleted something. I really needed those files. We do this from time to time. Let's click on files or folders and click next. Then we are prompted with different backup dates we can choose from and what the actual files were on. For example, my files here. Let's say, for example, I accidentally deleted some my YouTube videos before I've backed those up into actual physical stuff. And it tells me it's going to be on a virtual drive. Now, keep in mind, this is a virtual drive. It will look like the physical one that you have going now, but everything is completely virtual. And let's click on that and get started here. Okay, here I got a folder of all my YouTube videos. And see, this is what they look like before I uploaded to YouTube. And see the last file here, color calibration, you know, what I did. Let's say I have another one here, like the one I did earlier in the year, how to export, you know, video with, you know, transparent background. For example, if I wanted to restore that, I might have accidentally deleted it. I can click it and just simply drag it over to the desktop. And when I let go, give it a few seconds, and there it appears. So this has actually pulled this from the actual inside my backup drive and restored it back to the desktop. And it's simply that easy to restore your files and drives in a Shampoo Backup Pro 11. Okay, everyone, well, you see how easy it is to use. Let me talk about a few more things I really like about this software. Now, when your actual software is actually running, say if you run it during the day, and you actually need to use your computer, you don't have to worry about stopping the software to, say, edit photos or export video, anything. The software can automatically detect when you're actually using the system, and it can pause. For example, if you're wanting to do gaming and stuff in your off time and the software was running, well, you don't have to worry about stopping the software. As soon as you start gaming, the software sees that, you know, there's another application in the computer wanting to actually use the computer, so it just simply just pauses, which is really, really great. Now, the good thing is about backup software, especially like this one, there's a lot of this called ransomware going out now, where they can come out, lock your computer system up, and people demand you pay them money to get access back to your files. With this software, you don't have to worry about that. You can just go back, reset to the previous backup, and you never have to worry about that ransomware. So that way, you can take the power back, don't have to worry about nobody holding your photos and videos hostage. And also, the good thing is this also has, like I said, a rescue system, so you can actually boot it up and start your own your backup and restore it. Like, for example, if your operating system goes bad. So it does have UEFI support and everything. But yeah, I've been using the software for a while now. I really do like it. I think if I only had one bad thing to say about it is, since the software is so resource intensive, that I wish sometimes you could make it run just a little bit faster when you do want to hurry up. But normally it uses like 10% load on your CPU. So when you're sitting around not doing anything, it's just barely using 10%. If you do start using anything, it just kind of pauses. So yeah, I wish there was a turbo option or something to make it speed up. That way you can take a 3 or 4 hour backup. You might get done in an hour. Maybe if a Shampoo's listening, that might be something to consider. But other than that, I really do like this software. Like I said at the beginning of the video, this software offers really great value. Normally, the going price for this software is $39.99, but normally a Shampoo is always running deals and stuff on it. And currently, at the time of making this video, you can actually get this software for $9.99, of course, plus tax. And for $10, you really cannot beat this software. It is, it's just such a great value. You really can't. So anyway, I do like this software. I do highly recommend it. I do use this software. And like I said, if you want to purchase this software, it does help support this channel as well. But anyway, that's it for this review of the software. Like I said, I recommend it. You know, if nothing else, you can download a free trial of it, test it out, and see if you like it or not. And if you have any questions or anything about it, you can just ask me, and I'll probably have an answer. If not, A Shampoo's customer service is top notch. So if you ask, run any kind of questions or anything, they're normally very quick to respond back and help you out in any kind of situations. So anyway, that's this review, everyone. I hope you like it. If you do like this video, how about give me a thumbs up? Thumbs up is always highly appreciated. And if you're not a subscriber to my channel yet, then go ahead and take the time to subscribe. Subscribing is free. It's for you. It lets you know when I release more videos. And while you're at it, also check out my Amazon store as well as my Spreadshirt store. Links for those are down in the description below. I'll see everyone in the next video.